From the makers of Marvel, Paradise, and Lumity, I bring to you the Phonak Infinio. So there's no way that I'm going to be able to keep up that voice for this whole video, because today is going to be massive. So I'd recommend getting your popcorn ready and getting yourself comfortable, as you're going to want to be sat down for this one. In a recent poll that I put out there in YouTube land, 44% of you guys watching this channel wear Phonak hearing aids. And so today's video will be of particular interest. Saying that, only 264 people filled out this poll. And I know that this video is going to get a lot of traction, so I would love to know what you, yes, you, are wearing today. Are you wearing Phonak, Oticon, Signia, Resound, Starkey, Widex, or perhaps you're even wearing Jabra, Philips, or Rexton? Let me know in the comments beneath this video so I can tailor my videos for you going forwards. So I have to admit now that I'm very excited about today's launch, as I'm a big fan of Phonak hearing aids. You see, before running my own practice, I was working as a pediatric audiologist in the NHS, with Phonak hearing aids being the go-to choice. So that means for almost 20 years in audiology, they've played a huge part in my bringing adults and children back into the world of sound. So let's take a deep dive into what Phonak have got in store for us. At the time of making this video, which is pretty much launch day, Phonak Infinio is available in three different models. Firstly, the Audéo Infinio, which is their rechargeable receiver and canal style, and is essentially designed for versatility, being suitable for a range of different hearing losses, and is loaded with plenty of new features, which I'll come on to shortly. Secondly, we have Phonak's first ever rechargeable in-ear hearing aid, the Virto R Infinio. And I have to say, these things are absolutely beautiful. They support directional microphones, and of all of the in-ear hearing aids out there, these definitely win the award for the coolest looking. Finally, Phonak have a new Audéo Infinio Cross, specifically designed for those with a unilateral hearing loss who are in need of a cross or a bicross setup. And I'm delighted to share that with this new cross system, Phonak's attention has been on battery life with a 30% improvement, overcoming all the issues that they've had with their previous cross and bicross systems, as I think that Phonak would be the first out there to admit that this has been a little bit of a weakness of theirs in the past. Taking you on a physical tour now, they look pretty similar to Phonak's previous model, the Audéo Lumity, specifically the Lumity Life. However, they are a little bit shorter. You'll notice the microphones have dual ports for both the front and rear facing microphones, and there's been a slight modification to the positioning of the rocker switch, sitting a little lower than its predecessor. This rocker switch can be used for changing your programs, volume, and answering phone calls. And I'm particularly happy that Phonak have stuck with two buttons, as at the moment, all other manufacturers seem to be going towards a single button option nowadays. Finally, you'll see here the receiver wire, which feeds energy and information to the speaker, which sits inside your ear. As far as suitability goes, these are the fitting ranges for the interchangeable receiver wires. So whether you have a mild, moderate, severe, or profound hearing loss, they're technically suitable for you. I have also literally just had an email this morning confirming that active vent receivers are also compatible with these new hearing aids. Now, I won't go into detail today on exactly what active vent is. I will save that for my full review of these hearing aids, which will come out in a few months' time after I've fitted them in plenty of patients' ears and I've got some strong feedback for you. So make sure that you subscribe and press that grey notifications bell to be updated when I release that full detailed review video. As with previous Phonak receiver and canal hearing aids, the Infinios can also be customized to your ears and hearing loss by changing the tip on the end. And Phonak have a selection of medical grade silicon tips to choose from, ranging from open, closed, or power domes. Not only that, but one thing that's often overlooked by audiologists is having a custom tip made for the end of your hearing aid. And I personally try and put them on as many different people's hearing aids as possible. Of course, only when it's suitable though. So I guess one big question is, why is the tip on the end of the hearing aid so important? Well, in fact, the sound of your hearing aid will be completely transformed by changing it. For example, it can affect the clarity and sharpness coming from your hearing aid. It can affect how full and rich it sounds, how good it sounds when streaming from your phone, a Roger On system, or your TV, and most importantly for most of you out there, how well your hearing aids will cope when you're in background noise. So the misconception that hearing aid tips are just about comfort is not true at all. It affects way more than the comfort of your hearing aids. Moving on to the brand new design of the Virto R Infinio, which sits inside the ear and houses a push button, twin microphones for directionality, the charging contacts, and an LED here in the center. And something that particularly excites me is the fact that it has all of the same features of the receiver in Canal Infinio, meaning that there is no compromise on rechargeability, hearing in noise, tap control features, accelerometers, etc., etc., as there often are with in-ear models of hearing aids. And I will go into a lot more detail on all of those features shortly. If you're interested in having the custom model made, firstly, an impression needs to be taken of your ear and sent across to Phonak headquarters to be made, which this process normally takes around about 2 weeks. Phonak have also leveled up to ensure these hearing aids do not only just take into account your hearing test results and the shape of the mold, but they also take into account all of the acoustic properties of this part of your ear too. And I'll come on to what that means in a second. Phonak are boasting that these new hearing aids are custom built using biometric calibration, which minimizes sound leakage and maximizes sound quality. And it's pretty awesome how they do it. This biometric calibration process uses advanced imaging technology to create a detailed map of your ear, scanning the whole of the impression and predicting how sound bounces around before it hits the hearing aid microphone. This technically means that two people with identical hearing test results could have completely differently built hearing aids dictated by the shapes of their outer ears. Now, I'm pretty sure that that's everything worth mentioning from a physical point of view, so let's do a deep dive into all of the new features inside these hearing aids, starting with sound quality. If you're a bit of a geek like me and you manage to keep up to date with developments in hearing aid technology, you'll note that there are sometimes incremental changes in hearing aid developments. And then every few years, there tends to be big changes, and they tend to be born following the introduction of a brand new chip, which is exactly what we're seeing today from Phonak with the introduction of the ERA chip. And with this new chip, Phonak is shouting from the rooftops about 4 key developments. So firstly, we're seeing the introduction of APD 3.0, which is a brand new audiological fitting model replacing APD 2.0. And it uses up-to-date research on providing the most appropriate amount of sound needed to compensate for your specific hearing loss per frequency, without it sounding unnatural or overwhelming in any way. Now, Phonak's research states that 93%, that's 93%, it's massive, of those of you that have trialed this hearing aid already in their research phase prefer it to the sound of other leading competitors. I mean, you can't really argue with 93% now, can you? Moving on to AutoSense, which is one of my favorite adaptive programs out there that uses sophisticated algorithms that continually analyze the acoustic environment around you and make real-time adjustments to optimize sound clarity and comfort. That was a real mouthful. Now, Phonak have developed this even further in their Infinios by moving on to AutoSense 6.0, which enhances speech understanding by 16% and reduces listening effort by up to 45%, dynamically reducing background noise, making it easier for you to understand conversations without straining, meaning that you can rely more on your ears and far less on focusing on visual clues and contextual information, which means that you should ultimately be more relaxed and less tired when you're listening as well. This apparently should make the sound more natural and sharper and clearer, especially when you're in noisy environments. You're going to want to hear about Phonak's updates with Bluetooth, which, to be honest, were already incredibly unique as they were the only manufacturers that use classic Bluetooth, allowing you to connect to any Bluetooth device and not just smartphones. Yet they found a way to make themselves even more unique with 4 different developments. Can you tell that I'm a little bit excited by this? Firstly, Infinio's universal compatibility means it connects with all Bluetooth-enabled devices, including smartphones, tablets, and computers. This integration supports a wide range of audio codecs, ensuring high-quality streaming regardless of the source, and supports dual streaming too, allowing you to connect to multiple devices simultaneously, which isn't possible from any other manufacturer. Secondly, the Infinio also offers hands-free calling, which again is pretty limited with other hearing aid manufacturers. With the new chip ensuring instant connectivity, so your hearing aids are ready to use immediately after startup. And Phonak is stating that this is the lowest latency that they've ever been able to provide, meaning that there's no noticeable delay when switching between different audio sources. Thirdly, this new chip also allows for 6 times the transmission power of previous models, providing a far more stable and robust and faster connection, in fact. This increased power ensures consistent audio quality and connectivity over longer distances so that you can enjoy uninterrupted streaming and phone calls even with the device either in your bag, jacket, or just not on your person, which again is some issue that we've had not just from Phonak but other manufacturers in the past. And then finally, and news that you've all been waiting to hear, Infinio is also Auracast ready. So it's pretty standard now for most hearing aids to have built-in Bluetooth. But what you might not know is that the type of Bluetooth built into these hearing aids varies massively depending on the manufacturer that you choose. Well, I'm delighted to announce that Phonak have joined the likes of ReSound, Signia, and Oticon and included the latest version of LE Audio into their new technology, which I'm pretty sure is going to change your guys' listening experiences forever. And I honestly do not say that lightly. In short, you'll see an improvement in the Bluetooth capabilities with your phone when it comes to sound quality and battery consumption. And that's whether you're listening to phone calls, music, and the radio or podcast, all whilst keeping your phone in your pocket, which will give you a truly hands-free experience. But that's not everything. Where this technology will really take off is in any public venue that has a built-in Auracast transmitter. This new form of transmitter is specifically designed to work with newer LE audio technology and will send any signal to your hearing aids, such as if you walk into a football stadium and want to hear the commentary, or when you walk into a train station and want to hear the train announcements, or even if you head to a museum tour and you want to hear the tour guide with perfect clarity and distinction. So over the next few years, it's likely that we'll see public venues installing these Auracast transmitters, and Auracast broadcasted audio will replace the century-old loop systems that are currently built into public venues, allowing for multiple hearing aid users to simultaneously connect to audio in these public spaces. All with that improvement in sound quality and significantly lower battery consumption that I was talking about before. And trust me on this one, it's going to be a game changer. And that isn't just for people out there with hearing aids, but this is also people with regular headphones too. And so that's something that is going to get this off the ground sooner rather than later. Now, something worth noting, however, is that whilst this is built into the Infinios, it hasn't yet been activated. And that's the same with any hearing aid manufacturer. It will be done in the future with a simple and free firmware update. And does that matter? Well, not really, because at the moment there are no Auracast transmitters installed in any public venues. But I promise I will update you as soon as I hear about this happening. I will always welcome developments in durability that minimize the number of hearing aid breakdowns that we see in clinic. And I'm delighted that Phonak have made what was their previous life model their minimum standard now when it comes to robustness and water protection, which at the moment is only rivaled by Starkey with their Starkey Genesis AI hearing aids. Now, Phonak have done this by adding additional microphone protection. They have sealed the seams with silicone. They've coated the components with a Parylene coating, which I'm told is actually the same protection that NASA use on their spaceships. Then with all of that done, they have brutally tested this technology in the lab to ensure that it does exactly what they've promised. With a total of 135 different tests, including a simulated sweat test representing 2 workouts a week for a 5-year period, a seawater test, a saltwater test, a chlorinated water test simulating 2 swims per week over a 5-year period as well, and then finally freshwater testing performed in a pressurized chamber testing down to a depth of 50 centimeters 520 times. I really don't know what Phonak could have done to test these things any more than they already have. And with the positive track record that we've seen with the Lumity Lifes when it comes to waterproofing, I'm pretty confident that these won't fail on you if you jump in the shower wearing them by accident. Now, my full review on this technology will not be available for a while, as those of you that regularly tune into this channel know that I prefer to share the good, the bad, and the ugly after I've fitted them in a few patients' ears. In the meantime, I wouldn't recommend you making any decisions on the best hearing aid technology for you until you've seen this video on Phonak's biggest competition, the Oticon Intent Hearing Aid.